Hello friends. In this tutorial, I will teach you how to move water using dynamic bones. I create a new vector layer and change its name to glass. I make a glass with shape and rectangle tools. I create an arc for the edges with the curvature tool. I select the add point tool and disable the auto weld option. And I draw lines to create the shape of the glass. With the Create Shape tool, I select the glass and hold the Shift button. And select the extra lines. I change the color of the glass. I reduce its opacity. I change the color of the edges. I reduce its opacity. I select the Both option and click the Create Shape button. I make the color of the glass a little darker. I create a new vector layer and rename it to water. I draw a rectangle with the shape tool. I will make it blue and reduce its opacity. I select two layers and put them in a group. I select the water layer and select the points with the select tool. I click on the split option 5 times. I double click on the group layer and select the hide all option in the masking section. I move the shape of the water a little lower. I make a bone layer. I put the water layer inside the bone layer. I select the bone layer and create the bones. I select the bones and use Ctrl C and Ctrl V to make several copies of them. And I put them in the right place. I select all the bottom bones and connect them to the pin bone with the reparent tool. I select all the bones and reduce their strength. I select the bone layer and insert a hand layer from the library. From the animation section, I select the clear animation option and then frame layer to delete all the keyframes created in the hand layer. I change the location of the hand with the transform tool. I remove the hand from the group layer. I select both hand and group layers and put them inside another group. I determine the place of origin. I select the bone layer and select the bones in this order. I activate the bone dynamics option. These numbers are correct. I select the group layer and create keyframes. I put the slider in frame 60 and copy frame 36 to frame 60. I select all keyframes and select smooth. I select the last keyframe and then select the cycle option. Now I will press the play button to see the result. Thank you for being with me until the end of this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Bye until the next video.